This video will demonstrate a biparietal craniotomy for clip ligation of a superior sagittal sinus dural arteriovenous fistula. The patient was in her early 40s. Her dural arteriovenous fistula was treated with multiple rounds of embolization. This failed to obliterate the AV fistula completely. She was referred following this incomplete therapy. On neurological examination, she was intact. Here are her angiographic images, which demonstrate a superior sagittal sinus dural AV fistula with retrograde cortical venous drainage into a small vein that appears to arise from the falx and course inferiorly. It follows a circuitous route back to the superior sagittal sinus. A biparietal craniotomy was needed to expose this. The lateral patient position and the skin incision and craniotomy flap are shown here. Surgical strategy consisted of the lateral patient position with the nose turned to the floor, a biparietal craniotomy, identification of the arteriolized draining vein on the cortical surface, sharp arachnoid dissection to visualize the fistula originating from the falx, IC green video angiography to confirm the site of the fistula, clip ligation of the draining vein and division of the draining vein, repeat IC green video angiography to confirm the absence of shunting. Here's an overview of the surgical exposure with the back of the head at the top of your screen and the nose down towards the floor. The midline is in the center with the dura reflected over the superior sagittal sinus. The initial dissection is taking down these arachnoid granulations that adhere the medial parietal lobe to the falx. Now we see this large vein and just below it, this arteriolization. First, I need to dissect along the normal vein in order to better visualize the fistula site below. This is just some dissection along this vein to increase my space for working at the fistula. Now I've jumped in front of the same vein to free it on the opposite side. Here we see the arteriolized draining vein emerging from below that large vein. These arteriovenous fistulas come from the dural sinuses and have a clear arteriolized color. You can see how the fistula site is separate from this dark vein which overlies it. Indocyanine green video angiography showed the arteriovenous fistula to fill this vein underneath the large bridging vein first, and you can see that it bifurcates underneath the vein into two additional branching veins. The late phase of the video angiogram shows that the flow in these veins is retrograde from the sagittal sinus. This confirms the vein as the site of the fistula. Additional dissection here prepares it for clip application. The clip here is being applied to interrupt the outflow from the fistula site. With the clip application, you'll see that the draining veins immediately darken into this blue or purple color. The draining vein can now be cauterized and divided. I'm applying an additional clip here so that I can reposition the initial clip a little bit closer to the falx. I want to minimize the amount of this venous pouch between the fistula and the vein so that the risk of rupture is reduced. Now the clips are in optimal position, and you can see very nicely how these fistulas originate from this dural anatomy. Some of the feeding arteries reside in this layer of the falx, and here I'm just cauterizing them to occlude them. You can see how the cortical veins now are their normal dark color, and IC green video angiography shows that the once arteriolized draining veins are now normal in their color. No evidence of shunting was seen. Here we see the normal venous anatomy and the normal color within the veins. For good measure, I'm just dividing the vein a little bit further distal to the clips to ensure that there's no chance of connection to the fistula. These illustrations show the three different grades of dural AV fistulas in the Borden classification. Borden grade 1 AV fistulas drain into the normal sinus in an anterograde direction. The grade 2 fistulas drain both antegrade and retrograde into an arterialized cortical vein. Borden grade 3 fistulas drain retrograde into a cortical vein. The patient tolerated the procedure well. She had no new postoperative deficits and was discharged home on post-op day 2. Here, her postoperative angiogram confirms the absence of dural arteriovenous shunting. In conclusion, dural arteriovenous fistulas are abnormal arteriovenous connections within the dura that can present with hemorrhage or neurologic symptoms from venous hypertension. Treatment is indicated for DAVFs that drain retrograde into cortical veins, Borden grades 2 and 3. Most dural AVFs can be cured with endovascular embolization, and microsurgical venous interruption is reserved for those that fail endovascular therapy. Clinical and radiographic outcomes are excellent with microsurgical clip ligation. Thank you.